In this time value of money lecture, we're going to follow a step-by-step approach, and it is divided into two parts, part one and part two. Okay? For part one, we're going to cover the simple interest and compound interest, whereby under the compound interest, we're going to look at the future value, present value, finding the time period, finding the interest rate, effective annual rate, and also continuous compounding. Now, in this lecture, I'm not going to use the table, the manual table, and I'm not going to use financial calculator. All you need is a basic, decent scientific calculator for all the calculations. And I will provide many examples for you to understand the concept of time value of money. Now let's begin with the simple interest. And as the name simple means, it is not compounded, whereby interest is earned in each period only on the original principal. So if you look at the general formula, the basic formula, simple interest, in this case the SI there, is P is for the principal amount. Okay? If it is a loan, say a car loan, then it is the loan amount. Okay? Multiply by the simple interest rate, denoted by I here, and multiply by T is the number of period normally denoted in years. Okay? And that is to calculate the simple interest amount. So if we simplify it, it becomes P times R times T, or simply PRT. Okay? So for the T, okay, it is always denoted in years. So if let's say the time period involved is 6 months, then your T is 0.5. And if the time period is 18 months, T becomes 1.5. Okay? Let's look at the first example. Okay? Now, assuming a principal of $100 and a simple interest rate of 10%. Calculate the simple interest amount at the end of 5 years. So this is very simple. To calculate the simple interest amount, it is a principal 100 multiplied by the interest rate, which is 10%, multiplied by 5 years. So you end up with a simple interest of $50. Okay? Now notice that the original principal of $100, if you add with the interest of $50, it equals to $150. Okay? This $150 is called the accumulated amount, okay, or the future value of the principal, if you may. Now, the mathematical formula to find this future value of the simple interest is basically the principal plus the simple interest amount that you have calculated just now. Okay? And it can be simplified as such, P plus PRT, and finally it becomes P multiplied by, okay, use a bracket, 1 plus RT, where your R there is your simple interest rate and T is the time period in years. Okay? And we can use this formula to check our answer previously. So P times 1 plus RT is equals to 100 times, okay, 1 plus 0.1 times 5. So at the end, it equals to $150. Okay? Now let's look at another example for this simple interest. Okay? It can also be applied for a higher purchase or a car loan. Okay? So imagine upon graduating, you plan to purchase a brand new car, say for example, a Proton Persona. Okay? Now after paying the down payment, the loan amount is $50,000. Okay? And the interest rate, let's say it's 2.5%. Now you plan to apply for a 5-year loan, okay, because you don't want to be in debt for a long period of time. So what is the monthly installment? Okay, so the loan amount is $50,000. The loan period is 5 years. Interest rate is 2.5%. So first calculate your total interest. So for this loan, you actually pay 2.5% times 50,000 times 5 years. So the interest amount is $6,250. Your monthly interest equals to 6250, which is your total interest, divided by the number of months, which is 60 months. So it's 104. So you're basically paying an interest of 104 ringgit per month. Your total, your monthly installment, okay, is your loan amount, which is 50,000 plus the interest amount, which is 6,250, divided by the number of months, okay, for the loan period, which is 60 months. So it ends up to $937.50 per month. Now, of course, with the expected salary of around 2,500 to 3,000 for a fresh graduate, you may not afford this monthly payment. So you decide to apply for a 9-year loan instead. So now, what is the monthly installment with a 9-year loan? So applying the same method, right? Your monthly installment now becomes 567 ringgit and 13 cents. So now you may be able to afford to buy the new car, right, upon graduating.